Hello everyone, welcome to Daily Prelims Current Affairs by new IAS. Today on the 15th July, the topics we'll be dealing are United Nations Resolution 2428, Meerkat Telescope, National Commission for Protection of Child Rights and TPOX. The first topic for the day is United Nations Resolution 2428. The United Nations Security Council has adopted Resolution 2428. It is to impose arms embargo on South Sudan. So what is this resolution 2428? This resolution calls upon all UN member states to prevent supply, sale or transfer of arms to South Sudan through or from their territories till 31st May 2019. It also withholds training, technical and financial assistance related to military activities or materials. But there are some exceptions being laid, which is mainly with regard to material and activities related to humanitarian activities. Now let's take a look at the location of South Sudan. As you can see on the map, it is a landlocked country and it is located on the East Central African region. So as it is a landlocked country, it is surrounded by countries on all the sides. We have Sudan on the north, on the east we have Ethiopia, Kenya on the southeast, Uganda to the south, Democratic Republic of the Congo to the southwest and Central African Republic to the west. And talking about this United Nations Security Council, which has actually adopted this resolution 2428, it is one of the principal organs of the United Nations and it is in charge of maintaining international peace and security. An important point that is to be noted here is that it is the only UN body with the authority to issue binding resolutions. As we all know, it consists of 15 members, 5 permanent members and 10 non-permanent members. These non-permanent members are elected on a regional basis to serve a 2-year term. And the 5 permanent members are Russia, UK, France, China and USA. These permanent members have veto power. They can veto any Security Council resolution. For any resolution to be adopted, like this UN Security Council resolution 2428 and the resolution 2427 we saw last day, the resolution needs 9 votes in favor and no veto from any of the permanent members of this council. Moving on, the next topic is Meerkat Telescope. Meerkat Telescope was inaugurated in the South African town of Carnarvon. So, Meerkat Telescope is a radio telescope. Radio telescope means an astronomical instrument which consists of a radio receiver and an antenna that is used to detect radio frequency radiation that has been emitted by extraterrestrial sources. This Meerkat telescope will be incorporated into the complex square kilometer array instrument and this will become operational in the late 2020s. Then this Meerkat will be the world's biggest and most powerful telescope. So talking about this SAK or square kilometer array project, it is an international effort to build the world's largest radio telescope and it will be eventually over a square kilometers of collecting area. The SKA or square kilometer array will have thousands of dishes and a million of low frequency antennas that will enable the astronomers to survey the sky at a much faster pace than any current system in existence. And also the resolution quality of this SKA project will be much higher than the already existing Hubble Space Telescope. So there are around 11 countries that have been part of this project SKA. It is an organization. So there are organizations from 11 countries that have been part of this. India is a member of this SKA organization. The other countries are Australia, Canada, China, Spain, Italy, New Zealand, South Africa, Sweden, Netherlands and UK. These member nations are being marked in light blue color on the map. And this Meerkat a telescope will address some of the key science questions like the formation of these galaxies, the evolution of the galaxies, etc. The next topic is National Commission for Protection of Child Rights. Why this National Commission of Protection of Child Rights is in use is that they has prepared a guideline for regulating admission fee that has been levied by private unaided school. First, let's take a look at this model framework. It recommends setting up of a district fee regulatory committee in each district, and it will be headed by collector or district magistrate. Then every school has to submit a fee proposal online by October 31st with regard to the next academic section. And an algorithm will be used to calculate the minimum and maximum fee a school can charge. And this fees will be analyzed by this district fee regulatory committee in consultation with representatives from the parent teacher association, schools, etc. And then a fees will be finalized. And this fees that is being finalized will be applicable for the next 3 academic years. If a school doesn't submit its proposal, it may face a ban on new admissions. Also, if the schools are not satisfied with this finalized fee, then they can appeal to the state appellate authority, and the decision taken by this authority will be final. Now, let's try knowing more about this National Commission for Protection of Child Rights. It is a statutory body set up under the Commission for Protection of Child Rights Act 2005. It works under the Ministry of Women and Child Development. The Commission's mandate is to ensure that all laws, policies and programs are in accordance with the child rights perspective according to the Constitution and the UN Convention on the Rights of the Child. According to this NCPCR, a child is being defined as a person in the 0 to 18 years age group. The last topic for the day is TPOXX. The US Food and Drug Administration has approved TPOXX as the first treatment of smallpox in case the virus is being used in a terror attack. Talking about smallpox, this smallpox disease has been eradicated in 1980 thanks to an intensive vaccination camp. Even though it has been declared eradicated by this World Health Organization, there are concerns that the smallpox can be used as a bioweapon. This disease is being caused by a virus. The name of this virus is variola, and it is spread mainly by direct contact between people. The symptoms develop typically between 10 to 14 days after being infected, and the symptoms include fever, exhaustion, headache, backache, etc. Some of the complications of smallpox include encephalitis, that is inflammation of this brain, and corneal ulcerations, that is an open sore on the eyes, and blindness. Talking about this drug, TPOXX, it is a capsule taken twice daily for 14 days. The drug's effectiveness was checked with monkeys and rabbits, and it is a highly effective drug that more than 90% of these animals survived. Let's wind up today's session with the 2014 prelims question. Consider the following diseases: diphtheria, chickenpox, smallpox. Which of the above diseases have been eradicated in India? Option A, 1 and 2 only. Option B, 3 only. Option C, 1, 2 and 3. And option D, none. As we just know, this smallpox has been declared eradicated by the WHO in 1980. So the answer is B, 3 only. That is smallpox only. That's all for the day. For more news and detailed explanations, please refer to our new IAS current affairs material. Thank you for watching.